Soman's first time joining us, so he's a little late. New customer for the drill.
And ever since that started, right?
Check out the champion.
Hi.
Aryan Ram. What a nice name. Handsome boy. Lucky you forgot your gear. Because then because we don't want to spar in front of the kid, right? So wrestling is fine, but
he goes taekwondo, so he sees
this is very different from taekwondo.
Future championship fighter.
This is Soman.
Hello.
He was my photographer for the photo shoot. So if you make your photographer your training partner, it's a lot of benefits you can have.
Thinking about that, I brought your photos.
Will they allow me to see that?
It's okay.
Okay.
You can see, you can see.
Some young blood.
Chasing his father.
Can you go? Let's go.
Come on, chase up. Alright, chase up.
This one is not, it's not the exercise of how far you grow, but how you can engage the bottom with my power somewhere. Leg?
Good.
Okay. On the hand, right? Don't do the basketball lock.
Straight. Oh, straight.
Ready? Let's go.
Some hell sprints.
Careful of it.
The road man is enjoying. Last one.
Oh, still got.
Last one. Come on, give all. All out. Good job, Aryan.
It's crazy, man. Champion, come on. Say hi to the camera.
Say hello.
And the winner!
I think I'm cooled up.
Hey guys, it's the start of the week, and usually the first 2 days is when we'll like prep for our meetings and all that. We have a meeting that is I think on a Thursday and Wednesday if I'm not wrong. So today I'm heading out to get all the emails and whatever paperwork that needs to be get done.
I believe the key is to do what you're born to do, and I've heard people say that you must do what you're talented at. You have a lot of talents, so which one is it? You have from time to time you have different hobbies that come and go. So when you say you're born for something, it's not just something that you're talented and good at. And I think the best indicator of to know what you're born for is that if you're willing to do it for no money, if it ever were to come to the situation where your boss couldn't pay you, will you still be doing it? And if you're willing to do it, you just go. Say you are a farmer and you were born to be a farmer. No matter there's drought, rain, pestilence, whatever comes, you're still going to find some place where you're going to wait for a time to be a farmer. You're born to be a farmer and you make a difference in the world. You do something that you'll be a farmer that everybody, hey, that guy. Best or standing out, you make your mark. So when you say you're born for something, it's not just something that you're talented and good at.
Meeting got cancelled today. You look nice, man. Haircut and all that, don't look sure you still. Our meeting got cancelled, important meeting. But it happens, you know, once in a while. Still a lot of preparation, especially a director preparing. This happens as a filmmaker.
Some
sometimes the meetings don't go through. Two of you stood me up, man. Two of you, I texted you, you didn't reply me. You stood me up. I won't forget that. If you tell me that you're not interested, it's fine. But you shouldn't stand us up. I remember who you are. Thing is, if you're not interested in what we're doing, or if you don't think what we're doing is viable, then you should tell us. You know, you should say that you're not interested. But don't stand us up and don't send us a reply to our text messages and things like that. See, some of you are looking for precedence. You think that, something is viable only if there's a precedent. If that's the case, then how was Singapore formed, man?
The founders of Singapore went out to do what they did. Look at the words that you have. There was a time when people said that Singapore couldn't make it, but she did. There was a time when trouble seemed too much for her to take it, but she did. What does that mean? It means that Singapore was formed without a precedent. There's no precedent. So if you're looking for precedents, what we say is not viable. But if you look for things that have precedent, there will be things that become smaller and smaller. Man. How does Singapore survive on things that become smaller and smaller? There's no innovation. And what we are saying is to innovate, to be the leader in the market. So if you're not serious about us, just tell us. Send us a message, say that we're cowardly, or we don't dare. We have no courage. You know, every meeting is very important to us. The meeting got cancelled today. That's all right. It happens and it's for good reason. But the people who stand us up, and we take every meeting very seriously as filmmakers in Singapore. No meeting is too small for us, whether it's the first meeting, the third meeting, the fourth meeting. So we mean what we say. We mean business. We take it seriously. We take you seriously. So if you're not interested, say you're not interested. But don't stand us up. Why can't Singapore be the best? Why can't Singapore make it? Look at the people that's on the street. So many people. What's Singapore's capital? It's got human capital. What else does it have? Which industry won't be taken over by robotics? Creative industries. And that's where we should be. It's the creative industries. And if you production companies are going to do movies for other people from other countries and provide the services for them, how do we build an industry here with our people? How do we do that? There's a movie coming up done by Warner Brothers called Filthy Rich Asians, something like that. All Asian cast, shot in Singapore, made by Hollywood, sold to us. So they pay you production companies to do all their lead work inside. They give you your salary and then they sell it back to your country. And your money that they paid you goes back to them again. Yeah, Singapore at a time was supposed to be a service provider. But at this time, this is a new age. We must create the products. Which better industry than the film industry? But if our film production companies, if our production companies who have the equipment are not serious and are cowardly, where are we going to go from this? How are we going to move forward? We can't. So if you're cowards, just say it. You don't dare. But don't blame the environment, don't blame the government. Don't tell us that the situation in Singapore is not favorable. That's not true. It's just that you're afraid. That's the truth. You are afraid. There are people who are interested, so I'm happy about that. There are people forward-looking, I'm happy about that. There are people with a different mindset, who don't have the loser mindset. We want people who believe. We brought on cameramen who just want their salary, but they're like, they're just living from wage to wage just to make an earning and they're not going to give their best. We don't want that. We don't want a person with a loser mindset. Not that they're losers, and they are. They are people forward-looking. That's the people we want. And if you're not one of those people, it's fine with us. We're crazy, we're fearless, we're courageous, we're brave. And we want to work with the brave, the courageous, the crazy. And the people who believe it's possible. Of course, we have a strategy. It's not madness in that sense. There is a clear strategy. It's just whether you dare to take it. That's it.